Men and women of Reddit, what made you not want a second date with someone? Actually, I mentioned this situation the other day in another post but without details. I was at the mall one summer day hanging out with some friends. I see this guy who looked like a friend of mine, so I walked up to him only to find that he was not that friend. He was cute, we introduced ourselves, exchanged pleasantries, gave me his beeper number, I'm old, and we planned to go get coffee sometime. I was a hot spooky chick and he was a hot spooky dude. The day arrived, it turns out he worked at a Red Lobster down the road from my house, so I walked over there to meet him after his shift ended. We went to go see The Craft in the second run theater. We held hands, kissed during the movie. We went to go get coffee after and we chat. What year are you? Going to be a junior this fall. Cool. I didn't go to college. College? Oh god. How old are you? So that's the story about how two strangers vastly over-underestimated each other's ages. I thought he was 17-18. He thought I was around 20. I was 15 and he was 25. He took me right home and we didn't go out again. That must have scared the crap out of him. He spoke over me the whole time. At the end of the date he said I'd been too awkward because I hadn't spoken much, so he was going to frick me next time he saw me to break the ice. Needless to say, I did not see him again. Holy crap, that's so many bad things in one. 1. Talking over someone. Okay, fine. Maybe he gets nervous and doesn't talk a lot. Bad conversationalist, but a bad person. Benefit of the doubt. 2. Blaming you and calling you awkward. Zero self-awareness and kind of a dong. Lost my previous benefit of the doubt. 3. Telling he is going to frick you. WTF. I don't even know what to say. She showed up at the bar already so drunk that she could not walk without my assistance. 1. She drove herself there. 2. It was 2 in the afternoon. 3. She wanted to continue drinking as soon as we met there. There are red flags and then there are red flags. Yikes. I had more in common with the chaperone she brought to the ice cream shop, and didn't seem to have anything to say that wasn't as a godly person. Like, fine, you brought someone to make sure I wasn't a creeper, I understand that, but when you make it very clear that it's your youth pastor acting as the chaperone, and invite him to sit at our table, then say nothing until the pastor felt bad enough to break the silence to talk to me. Maybe don't cry and ask why I don't want a second date. We'd been to lunch a few times but this was the first real romantic date. We met in biology class in college. She was gorgeous and smart and had a smile that could melt diamonds. I was in a group project with her and took her to lunch, and she confessed she had a crush on me. So we kissed before going back to class and made plans for a date and went out that night. And we had a wonderful time. Until about the time she asked me what my deal breaker for dating was. As in, what trait would someone have that would immediately make me break it off? I said something like I wouldn't date a racist or a puppy kicker. Someone who had a sociopathic streak, or was mean, stuff like that. She said that she could date all kinds of guys. Fat, skinny, black, white, it didn't matter. The one thing she could not abide, the one kind of guy that she absolutely, positively, would never, ever, like ever be with, was a guy with a hairy back. I'm Iranian. The end. She probably secretly was a mean, racist, puppy kicker, and used that to break it off. It was my first and only blind date which a mutual friend of ours set up. She arrived and parked in a disabled space, got out of the car telling me she uses her nan's disabled pass, which didn't sit well with me but carried on anyway. We went bowling and to dinner. She was really rude to the service staff in both places, which I found embarrassing and uncomfortable. Cut the dinner short, paid, left and never saw her again. Oh, you were this close to spending a life where she eventually takes the kids. This happened last week. When we got to the good old what you do for a living, she straight up tried to sell me in on her MLM scheme. When I politely noted I wasn't interested but I'm happy to go back to our previous discussion, she got argumentative in the good old salesperson losing a client kind of way. When it was clear the mood was ruined and we weren't going anywhere from there, I stood up, paid for our drinks at the counter, and got out. Bonus points for some of my friends coincidentally sitting at the table behind us. her. I could see them and giving her weird looks as she was ranting about the life-changing opportunity. That pretty much solidified my thoughts. You got honed. Matched with a guy on Tinder in 2014 while I was in grad school and new to the city I was living in. He seemed cool enough and lived in a small town about 45 minutes outside my city. He offered to take me out for dinner, and I agreed and said I would meet him at dinner. In regard to my own safety, he insisted on picking me up and showed up with a liter of Fireball and sat down on my couch and started pouring shots of it for me and my roommate. He seemed like a genuinely nice guy, just oddly misguided in that I was not interested in binge drinking Fireball before dinner. He ended up drinking nearly all of it and tried to hook up with me. When I rejected him, he wanted to drive home despite being completely wasted. I forced him to sleep on my couch and locked the door to my room. We never spoke again, but he did try to add me on Snapchat about 4 years later. Sheesh, what a mess he was. She had already put our pictures through one of those "what would your baby look like" apps and started talking about how we would raise them. I've heard of men talking about that before, but yikes. Yeah, dodge that bullet and run like the wind. My time to shine. Went on a date with a guy, who I have dubbed PowerPoint Guy. He arrived at our first date, coffee, with a literal presentation of non-negotiable demands he required from a future partner, including, but not limited to, must be housewife, produce him two boys and a girl, in that order, gender specified, not work or desire a career, move 500 miles away to live on an acreage in his parents' house, like, with them also living there, not have any male friends, but he also wanted someone who is open to sleeping with whoever he chose so he could watch. The list goes on. He didn't ask me a single question about my life or interests. Just spat out this list of stuff and talked about himself for 2 hours. At which point, I politely bailed. Props to this guy for knowing what he wants, but PowerPoint Guy did not land a second date with me. PowerPoint Guy is a really generous nickname. He said, yeah, you're an engineer now, but once you get pregnant you'll move away from working though, right? Just so many assumptions in the one statement. Hadn't even gotten our food yet. Broad and bold assumptions with little to no data, an immediate red flag for any engineer. He invited me to smoke a joint with him at his house. Turned out he lived with his mom. That's okay. So we smoked in the garage with giant cockroaches running around. That's not okay. Nice and simple. An acegeneral gets it out of the way early. I guess I better tell you that I'm going to expect you to stop talking to any other girls you might have in your life. She then explains, yes, everyone. No, she's serious. She gets jealous easily. That one was the only first date I ever ended early. Even the one where the woman brought her little brother I saw through. So you got ghosted. She criticized absolutely everything. The car I was driving, clothes I was wearing, cologne I chose. We were supposed to go bowling, dinner and then drinks. When an attendant came over to ask if we wanted anything, I ordered my snacks and asked if she wanted anything. You mean you don't know? What kind of date is this? Halfway through our game she mentioned I was bringing up the wrong conversation topics. Thankfully my brother called me out of the blue asking to borrow some fishing gear and I played it as work calling me in. I couldn't get out of there fast enough. He started stalking me and followed me home from the thrift store. Another guy told me we'd have 8 kids within minutes of meeting in person. He was adamant. I met a girl at work who decided to invite me over to her house to hang out. Everything was cool until I went to the bathroom. The bathroom was an absolute wreck. Hadn't been cleaned in maybe years. There was scum and hair everywhere. I could have dealt with all that, but when I raised the lid to take a pee I saw turd floating in some water and pee with a piece of toilet paper over it. She had just been in there a bit before myself. I flushed, peed and then called it a night. Me too had the same experience with a guy and he kept wanting to connect. I was disgusted forever. She wanted me to join her MLM. Said the only way she could get platinum is if she marries someone who is in the MLM and they combine their sales. That's one of the cringiest things I've ever read. Showed me his giant back tattoo of a demonic Jack in the Box while in a bookstore. A date location he picked and I foolishly thought we might have interesting discussion on Reading. Turns out, he rarely read and it was just the only place in my city he was familiar with. comma doesn't read, or write. I guess it's not for everyone, comma bookstore is the only place in your city he was familiar with. This just raises more questions. First date was uneventful. We talked about what we did, our backgrounds, upbringing, etc. Vapid, nebulous stuff. This was late afternoon Saturday. We parted and I went to a pub to meet some friends. The following morning I slept late and opened my phone to a barrage. Well, around 4 of messages from my date. She's listing all the things I should have done or said better, what she found annoying, etc. I'm looking through it pretty damned hurt. I started to write what I thought. Wow, there's no need for that. Just say thanks and bye, but remember to not text when emotions run high. That afternoon, another message. When do you want to try again? Think it could be fun. This time I did respond. Never. Jesus, I feel bad for the kind of low self-esteem having folks she wants to lord over. They said I've never dated a communist before. I was born and raised in America. It was so creepy being fetishized just because I'm Slav. Yeah, we all salute to Lenin's portraying every morning when we wake up. Realizing that she had no interest and only wanted a free meal. When someone makes you feel used, that is just enough reason to not have a second date, independent of the gender. I know a woman who pulls this crap and is proud of it. She was an old colleague and I just used to ignore her, but she would tell everyone about her free meal anyway. Freaking vile pieces of crap. Just to clarify, she could afford it. She had money for Fears and Gucci. Different guy. I told him I'm not much of a kisser even before the date, that I show intimacy in other ways. The day had been great. Then at the end he was catching the train, and just before he jumped on he leaned in to kiss me, which I dodged, and he went straight on the train. Cause he'd left it at an awkward time, just as he was leaving. I didn't have chance to hug him or do anything else. Rather than responding maturely, he sent me loads of insults over Snapchat, then 2 days later claimed his mate sent them and he wanted to see me again. Dang, and I thought my luck with men was bad. I feel like I should preface this, I'm a gay guy. I started dating when I moved to Seattle. Of course I got on Tinder, went out with what I thought was a really sweet guy. He was generous, funny, and overall very charming. He ended up being incredibly clingy to where it was just exhausting. Before our almost second date he would constantly text me at work, and when I didn't respond, he would send me an insane amount of texts until I responded. It's so weird that he started act like this after we first met. I'm a needy guy myself, but this was so exhausting. Nope, nope, never again. Yikes, yeah, there's a limit to everything, like, leave me alone, I am at work. This chick I went on a date with sat on her phone almost the whole time. I think she even answered a call from her ex while I was in the middle of talking to her. If you didn't want to come on the date, why come in the first place? Probably wanted a free meal. We went for a 1-hour walk and during that time he let me say about a total of 10 words and spent the rest of the time talking to me about his money or answering his own questions. Wouldn't sleep with her and she said I was putting her in the friend zone. I wanted to be like, you're still in the I don't know you zone. Chill. A lady I knew used to hassle me about taking her out one night. I was friends with her sister at the time and she said her sister was keen to go out with me. Even her mother wanted me to take her out. So we arranged to go for a drink. She turns up with another guy who just sits there and says nothing the whole time. After about 30 minutes of awkwardness she says to her friend, right, shall we make a move, and off they go. Fast forward 3 or 4 years and we're at her sister's wedding. Girl I took out starts moaning at me for not taking her out again. I just smiled and walked away. Huh, that's odd to say the least. She invited me to watch some movies in her dorm one night at college. I was expecting either a cheesy rom-com or a brainless action flick we could talk over. When I arrive, she asks if I like scary movies. They're okay, but not what I usually watch. I agreed to watch one, something I had never heard of but looked like it would probably be a silly slasher that's more fake blood than actual plot. Nope. 3. She just kept putting the next one on without stopping and I have trouble speaking up for myself in stressful situations. Psychological horror movies later, I walked back across campus by myself at 2 a.m. Anxiety through the roof and on the verge of a panic attack. Never texted her back. She was talking to her 30-year-old son on the phone in a very creepy way. Babes, sweetie and other crap whilst slightly leaning over on her bar stool farting constantly. Kept talking about the last person she went out with and everything they did wrong. Throughout the date, talked about how she used to compete in judo with Ronda Rousey in high school and how much she now hates Ronda Rousey. Talked extensively about how hard she is working on losing weight and trying to get back down to her fighting weight. Then at the end of the date, bought 4 full pies to take home for herself. Lomfeo. Okay, this is a little weird, but he talked, at length, about how he hates vegetables and doesn't eat them. It just made him seem like a bit of a baby. Hum. Sounds like my buddy Steve. His tagline was veggie free since 2003. Years ago I scored a date with this absolute bombshell. Totally out of my league. And she came onto me. Too good to be true apparently. She was fine over messages. But when we actually went for coffee together she was the most conceited bee I've ever met. Since I didn't live my life exactly like she did I was a knuckle-dragging loser. I don't think she had a single nice thing to say about me, or anything else for that matter. She asked me to a staff dinner or something a couple days later and I politely declined. I actually feel bad that I wasn't honest with why I didn't follow up with her, but a while ago I went on a date with a girl who was seemingly very sweet and very attractive. Probably out of my league. We had a good time hanging out at a bar restaurant and we liked a lot of similar things and she was studying to be a nurse and had an internship. Cool. But then she told me that part of her internship was helping with schizophrenic patients as well as other mentally handicapped individuals. And one thing she thought was hilarious was to frick with them. She told me she liked to mess with the schizophrenics by telling them things like "Yeah, I really am out to get you" and things of that nature. When she said this I just said that my grandmother was heavily schizophrenic and it's a very serious and harsh problem and I felt bad for them. It ended the conversation but the date proceeded for a bit longer before ending and we parted ways. She definitely wanted to do it again but I just couldn't after that. Not sure if she just kind of said something she thought goofy in the moment and didn't actually do those things but either way it was a deal breaker for me for sure. I also had no actual clue where she worked so before anyone asks I couldn't have really reported her or anything like that. You did the right thing. What she was doing was pure evil. Hope she is a better person now. Told me he slept with 3 of his previous students. Sadly, this was 3 months into the relationship and not technically a second date. Arrived 40 minutes late with no text to say he would be. Turned up with his laptop and said he needs to do some work and gave me some cash to get him a coffee and something I want. I was like okay sure and stood in the queue watching him as he put on his headphones and opened his laptop. I came back with the drinks and he said he just needs to finish this and took a call. I just sat there for another 40 minutes with zero conversation and him typing chatting away. This was a Saturday BTW and he scheduled the time. After he finished he said let's go to a bar and get a proper drink. We had a chat and I tried to get to know him but he was being an ass. He ordered the drinks and then started having a go at me for not offering to pay and went on a rant about double standards. TBH I was still pissed off about waiting around for 90 minutes and was not in the mood to pay for his drink or see him again. He was the most attractive guy I had ever dated. Unfortunately he was not passionate about anything. He was just kind of there. That's what we call an NPC. She was rude to her parents. And they weren't abusive or negative towards her from what her friends would mention or speak about. And they were fine. She was just entitled in general. Wasn't the first date but the second. She and I hung out once and things were pretty cool. We decided to hang out a second time and while we hung out she told me about being divorced twice and essentially said was looking for a new father for her son who was removed from her care. Keep in mind we had talked off and on 3 months prior to ever meeting up and she never mentioned that she had a kid or had been married. I was only 19 at the time. Couldn't have dodged that bullet any better. All he kept talking about the entire date was how, in the future, self-driving cars would be way better than people could ever drive and this would be the ideal way. I questioned that idea, not really knowing enough about the subjects to have an informed opinion, but just going off what he was saying, and he made me regret it for the next hour. Then he insisted that no matter how good a driver I was, a computer would always be better. He wouldn't shut up about self-driving cars the entire time. to this day I hate the whole idea of it, mostly because of him. I went to see this band play at a record store with a girl from my business class. As the guy is counting change, she laughs and goes, "This guy definitely isn't in business school," directly in front of him. I gave her a brief look of disgust and continued to the band. For the rest of the night, she scanned through records while I danced to the band in the other room. I think she knew at that moment as well that we weren't compatible, mainly because she was so disrespectful and I didn't entertain it at all. Gave her a ride home after, but we definitely never went on a second date. You, my man, did everything right. To start, he was nearly 30 minutes late to the restaurant. Blamed traffic for being so late, even though we don't live in a city. He was a little drunk when he turned up, but I can understand if he was a little nervous beforehand. I ordered a meal and he ordered 3 beers for himself. After he downed a few, he then proceeded to tell me I was a 7 out of 10, and to get to a 10 I should get plastic surgery so I can be a model. I told him repeatedly that I was happy with the way I looked, but he kept going on and on about what I should get done. After I'd finished eating, I said I'm going to pay for my meal then head home. He wanted to go to the bar and convinced me to go with him. I ordered a drink then turned around to see him leaning over a couple of young ladies, who looked pretty uncomfortable. So I put my drink down and left. I sent him a text the next day saying it isn't going to work and blocked him. 1 week later I get a call from an unknown number and it's him mum. She tells me about how he came to visit her and told her all about me, and how happy she is that her boy has finally found someone, then invites me to dinner, which I turned down. She would not shut up about AA. Her whole life and personality revolved around it. I wanted to leave before the food even arrived. Felt her baby bump when she gave me a goodnight kiss. Turned out she was pregnant with a friend of mine's kid but didn't tell me that before we went out. It sucked. I liked her and we had had a good time together. Met a girl on Plenty of Fish. She sent pics. She was attractive. We arranged to meet at a local restaurant. I text her when I get there and wait to walk in with her. She gets out of her car and is 3 times the size of her photos. I'm not handsome by any means, but this was pure false advertisement. I couldn't be mean about it though. I just took her in the place and bought her dinner and we had great conversation. I may have even done a second date, but then she texted me to honestly tell me she had herpes. Looking back, I think that is a super thing to come clean and reveal to someone. A lot of people do not and that sucks. The herpes and the size difference were it for me though. I was out. Never did or will do a dating app again. Not for me. I'm just baffled at how she'd lie about her looks but be completely honest about having herpes via text with no apparent prompt on the topic. But she kept talking about how life was supposed to be enjoyed to the maximum. Basically, how she spent lavishly on expensive Italian, French or Japanese dinners and trips, making her constantly broke and constantly borrowing money from other people to sustain her lifestyle. She considered it classy, I considered her delusional. And surprisingly, I ran for the hills, as fast as my legs could carry me. No thank you. I got in contact with a guy on Tinder once that seemed nice at first, but after a few hours of chatting there were massive red flags. He wanted me to come over and didn't accept a no. This was a family day for me and I wanted to spend time with them, to kinda understand me better in this situation. This was just 2 months after I quit a 5-year-long extreme toxic relationship, so I was a massive people pleaser at the time. So when he didn't give up and made me feel guilty, said he already told his friends he has no time because he wants to meet up with me, that he is now lonely f and so on. I couldn't stand it anymore and drove the 45 minutes to his house, at 11 p.m. to a guy I only knew a few hours and was a typical nice guy. Yep, I was that dumb. I packed a knife in my sleeve just in case. He was awful, just talked about himself, talked me over and tried to make me drunk so I couldn't drive anymore. I stayed 3 hours out of guilt and because I didn't want to be rude. Then I drove off and was so happy to be home again. I wrote him a message the next day that there won't be a second date and he said something between the lines of "we'll see." Bombed me with texts the next day so I blocked him and he started stalking. Texted me insults every 2 days for half a year. He was the reason I deinstalled Tinder and stayed single another year. Enrico, if you ever see this, you're an absolute scumbag. If you- you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.